Dear Mr. On, I read with interest the online description and pictures of Odd's Inn and found it very appealing. I am planning a trip to visit Scotland, and I would very much like to reserve one room for 9 days. Those dates to be advised. Sincerely, Annabel Wilson.
Dear Ms. Wilson, I am delighted to receive and confirm your reservation for the dates you request. I'm sure you will find our elegant, historic inn to be all we represented on our website. I will be at the train station to meet you personally and to transport you to Odd's Inn. Please give me a brief description of yourself so I can identify you easily in the crowd, or, if you prefer, a recent photo.
Thank you, Mr. Odd. Well, I have no recent photos, but I am a woman of a certain age who's blonde, 5'6", and completely ordinary in every way. You told me over and over again that we would always have each other. But you were wrong about that, weren't you? I love you, Fred. And I always will. But I gotta make new memories, or the old ones are gonna kill me. And I'm not ready to die. Not yet.
Gavin?
What are you doing here?
I'm waiting for the guest.
The guest?
The guest? What are you doing here?
Waiting on the wife. She was visiting her widowed sister in Glasgow. Remember the one I was telling you about? She's got the hots for you, you know. Yeah. After her husband died by accidentally dropping his electric razor into the bathtub. Fried every hair off his sorry arse.
Can it be a worse way to go?
Nah, tell me about it. Had to clean up the plumbing afterwards. Phew. Oh, there's Winnie. See you later.
Here you go, Gavin.
Mr. Ott?
Miss Wilson.
Yes, hi.
Hello, welcome.
Oh, hello, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Thank you for meeting my train. It's been a long trip.
Well, we at Odds Inn pride ourselves in our impeccable service and hospitality.
Good.
Yeah.
Good, then I'll be an excellent customer for you.
Good, good.
Okay.
Is this it?
Yeah. This is my only suitcase. My zipper's broken.
I think there's some pills for that now.
Excuse me?
Just a bit of Scottish humor, no offense.
None taken. Yeah, it's very, very light. There's really nothing in it but this little costume I found. And then I'm going to buy all new everythings.
Okay.
And then I'm going to go to Italy and I'm going to buy a brand new one. Because that's the next place on my list.
Oh, you've got a list.
I do. I have a great list. And by the way, your railroads?
Yes.
Are really lovely.
They're not mine.
I gather they're not yours, but I mean, they're comfortable and it's just really clean.
Oh, okay.
I don't know why I did expect it, like, filthy or something.
Well, you thought Scotland would have dirty trains?
No, I would just... Scotland's so old. So I just figured the trains would be old.
The trains were invented at the same time everywhere around the world.
Oh, it's so beautiful.
Yep.
How far is it to the inn?
Not far. You know, just a short drive. Well, a lot. It depends on what you think short and long. We drive where the wheel is.
Oh, gotta get used to that.
Yep, there you go.
I smell gas.
We call it petrol here, and it's the reason I'm putting this on. It's flame retardant.
What?
Do you have anything? Put your coat on or something, just in case. I mean, you're fine.
This isn't flame retardant.
Well, it'll keep you warm going through the glens, and that's important. We're not going to go on fire or anything. It's just... You can never be too careful.
You put that on every time you drive your car?
No, not every time. When it's raining, I don't wear it.
But when it's raining, don't you put a top on?
No, I go faster and then the rain can't reach me.
Oh, I see. You're messing with me.
I am not messing with you.
Freshly in Scotland. Okay, I'm on to you now.
Okay.
I'm on to you.
You all right?
I am so cozy.
You got your seatbelt on? That's a joke, because...
Yeah, there's no seatbelt.
No seatbelt, there you go.
Oh, look at this. Oh, wow. I'm expecting a very important letter. Does the mail arrive here every day?
Yes, it arrives daily, like it does in every modern country, on a nice, clean train.
I've never seen so many sheep.
Yep, there are over 7 million sheep in Scotland. Only 5 million people. I prefer the sheep.
You're kidding, right?
Nope. Is this your first time in Scotland?
My first time anywhere, really. I've never seen anything except through the movies. And by the time I've done with this trip, I'll have seen the whole world. Oh, I love that song. It's so catchy.
I'll bring the whiskey.
I don't like that song. It's all they play. I have a joke. There's a doctor and he's worried about... having sex with his patients. And then a voice in his head says, don't worry, a lot of doctors have sex with their patients. And then another voice in his head says, yes, but they're probably not veterinarians. It's a wee bit of Scottish humour there. It's not for everybody. It's like haggis. I think it's the fan belt or the alternator.
It's neither one. You're out of gas.
We call it petrol.
Well, whatever you call it, you're out of it. How far is this in?
It's not far, just down the road a bit.
I'm gonna walk, okay? I'm gonna walk.
Look, you can't walk on that road. You'll need something on your feet. Here.
I'll be fine.
No, take these. Put these on.
You have women's boots in your trunk?
We call it a boot.
You have women's boots in your boots?
I do. Do you want them or not?
Fine, thank you.
Just follow the road.
Hi, Gavin, it's me. Yeah. I think I've run out of petrol.
Oh, there is? Well, why did you say that, then? Could it be the alternator, maybe, or the fan belt?
No.
All right. Yep, fine, thanks. Okay, bye. Oh, jeez. Oh. Don't worry about Wally, he's very friendly. Just let him sniff you. Any part.
So much more beautiful than the pictures. It's just gorgeous, beautiful bones.
Well, you better have great bones if you're 400 years old.
I can't even imagine the upkeep on a place like this.
No, you cannot.
So pretty.
Yeah. Oh, I love these. Can I have one of your sweeties?
What's a sweetie?
You know your box of chocolates here.
Oh, no. That's not a box of chocolates. I'm sorry, that's my husband.
Okay.
Fred, my late husband, though he was never late. It's a stupid phrase.
That's a box of chocolates.
Yes.
That somebody has laminated shut.
And that would be me. And I did it on purpose because otherwise he would spill.
Oh. Fred's in the box?
Most of them.
Don't they have unused containers for that sort of thing? You know, urns?
Yeah, they do. And a lot of people prefer to do that, but Fred didn't want that. I was executor of his will. I had to respect his wishes.
He was mental?
No, he was not mental. He had an accident. We had a hardware store and that he'd gone up and down the ladder for 31 years, and this one time he went up and came down and broke his neck.
That's a terrible story. I'm sorry for your loss.
Still, it doesn't quite explain why he's inside a box of chocolates about to check into my inn, does it? So,
Fred and I loved movies. Forrest Gump was his favorite movie. Mm-hmm. We always said that whenever he left this world, it was going to be the only kind of box he would be in. So.
Well, I hope your favorite movie isn't Psycho, and I'll have to keep you out of the shower.
I'd prefer a bath than a shower, please, in my room.
Okay. Can I see your passport?
Oh, yes. No need to check my age.
Of course not.
You're checking my age, aren't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Just out of curiosity, what's your favorite movie?
Funny Girl.
Barbra Streisand.
Yes, but playing Fanny Bryce.
I know who she was, a famous Broadway actress.
Yes, but much more than that. She was a singer, and she was a comedian, and she was fearless and brilliant. Everything I wanted to be.
Oh, good for you.
Never happened. Is this the way?
Yeah, up the stairs.
Okay.
You forgot your case?
No, I didn't. You really need to check those pipes.
Just old plumbing.
Second alcove on the right, Mrs. Wilson.
So you're in show business, then?
Nah, I wanted to be, but I met my husband, and... Oh, that hot, hot, crazy summer. You know, it was a big hit back then. So.
I don't know. And yeah.
Oh, okay, great.
So you gave up your dreams of show business for Fred?
No, I just chose a different kind of life with Fred.
Right. A man who wanted to be cremated, then put in a chocolate box, then laminate it, and go sightseeing.
No, but I wouldn't expect anybody to understand.
All right.
Here's your case.
Dinner's at 7.
Thank you, but I'm not hungry.
Oh, you will be.
Oh, I do need a safe, though. Is there one in the room?
Yep, there's I don't think it's big enough for Fred, though.
It's not for Fred. It's for his mother.
Oh, wow. Didn't know Mel Gibson was having a yard sale.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mrs. Wilson. Are you hungry enough for a bite? How's Fred?
I would love a cup of coffee, thank you, and a poached egg. And I'd really appreciate you not mentioning Fred. It's disrespectful.
Okay. Sit at any table that's not occupied, and I'll see how the chef's doing with your breakfast.
None of them are occupied.
Well, sit at one of them, then.
Okay.
Did manage to save the salmon. We have a smoked salmon and a poached salmon, and we've got everybody's favorite salmon.
What happens if a guest doesn't particularly like salmon?
Then they starve to death or they have the haggis.
What is this haggis everybody talks about?
Well, haggis is a sort of a sausage. It's made from the heart and liver and lungs of a sheep, mixed with some oatmeal, and then cooked slowly inside the sheep's stomach lining.
Well, can I get the oatmeal without all the vital organs?
No.
I love salmon.
Salmon is.
Oh, you've made her mad now, Giuseppe. She's never going to be happy until she gets that coffee. I'm about to try my best. Well, you've disappointed me for the last time. You are fired. No, please, boss, come back.
You're just not up to the standards we expect here at Odds Inn for our important American guests.
Ah! I'm so sorry.
I'll have tea.
Fine.
What do you say, Wally? Shall we go into town, huh? I need a little retail fair.
How do I begin to begin?
Kitchen's closed.
Oh, that's okay. I'm not hungry. I had a bite at the village earlier. Thanks.
Well, then you won't be interested then in the beautiful tuna steak that I have benevolently set aside for you, because I feel bad about belittling poor Fred.
You needn't have bothered, but that's very nice. Thank you.
Listen to Mrs. Wilson. Scotland is cold enough. Let's put aside our differences.
And I have to tell you, what you're doing with Fred, it's fascinating. Really, it's fascinating.
What do you really want, Mr. Ott?
I want what I want for all my guests. I want them to enjoy the Odds Inn experience.
Are you hungry? Please. Will Mrs. Odd be joining us tonight?
Sadly, no. Mrs. Odd has, well, she's in the same place as Fred is, probably right about now.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, don't be. She was a miserable sow.
So you wanted to be in show biz?
Well, yes, I wanted to be in show business, but that ship sailed, much like the Titanic.
That's a movie that wasn't on your list.
You saw my list?
Well, I'm short of staff, so I do the housekeeping as well, and, you know, the list was on your desk next to Fred when you went for your run.
Well, I hope that's all you saw.
I saw your Spanx.
I don't wear Spanx, so it had to be running shorts. I run every day. I don't wear Spanx.
Well, you'd be the only woman in the history of the world that doesn't wear Spanx.
Well, I just don't like being held in anymore in my life, you know?
Good for you.
Yeah.
My brave heart. I have to tell you, that's actually a movie, by the way, that I cannot stand.
What?
Braveheart, I hate it. You have to keep that secret in Scotland.
Well, your secret is obviously safe with me.
Well, secrets are easy. It is the truth that is difficult.
Oh, well, what philosopher came up with that genius? You seem to like the potatoes, right?
The brilliant, but sadly very obscure, Lord Howard Odd.
No.
Oh, yes. Still technically a lord. Descended from generations of Scottish nobility.
Huh. So how long were you married?
Oh, who knows? Tell me about Nantucket.
Oh, Nantucket's gorgeous. You've never been?
Never been. Don't know anything about it. Well, wait, there's a poem about it.
Yeah, that's the problem. Everybody knows the poem. And hardly anybody's been to the island. It's beautiful. You'd love it.
Isn't that where the Pequod set sail from Nantucket? In Moby Dick?
Herman Melville's novel, yes. But I hated it.
What?
I hated it.
You hate Moby Dick?
Yes, I do.
And you live in Nantucket?
I have secrets too, all right? But I hate it. I couldn't get
you
through.
You live in Nantucket and you hate Moby Dick?
Yes, well, you live in Scotland and you hate Braveheart. Same thing.
Well, it's a stupid movie. The idea of William Wallace having an Australian accent, running around Scotland in a tartan dress, having sex with the Queen of France, it makes no sense at all.
He didn't have sex with the Queen of France?
Nobody has sex with the Queen of France. Even the Queen of France. Well, the King of France. The Queen of France might have had sex with herself. You know what the French are like.
No, I've never been to France.
Have you never? Oh, well, I have to tell you, you'll get a fright. They're at themselves the whole time.
Oh, that's good. Your chef is excellent.
Yes, he is pretty good. Would you like a pudding?
Sure. What kind do you have?
I have spotted dick. Americans always say that. Right, but
is that a real thing?
It's a real thing.
My mother warned me about spotted dicks.
Well, your mother was right.
Oh, the loch is gorgeous in the moonlight. Will you take me fishing?
No, of course I'd be happy to take you out as part of your Odds Inn experience.
Which I am thoroughly enjoying.
Good, I'm glad. We aim to please. I told you we were short-staffed. We're short-staffed. You think rubbish just picks itself up and puts itself away because it's dirty and smelly and nobody likes it?
No, I don't think that. Do you need some help?
Oh, sure. You're going to come down here in your sexy pajama top and get rubbish juice all over yourself. No, no, I think we'll be fine. Thank you.
I will do that if you ask me nicely, Romeo. What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Oh, yeah, I got him. Oh, yeah.
Don't do that. He's never seen a woman's legs before.
Well, he's seen some sheep legs, haven't you, Gavin?
You shag one sheep.
Put some clothes on, for goodness sake, you're in Scotland.
Hey, Gavin, a little Scottish humor. No offense intended. Have fun, boys. Then came you. Like a da 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 da. Oh!
Stop it!
Oh! Howard! There's no water! Howard! Howard! Howard!
No! I'm down here in the basement.
Why are we whispering?
We're whispering because I don't know what's down there. Because I don't really go into the basement. It's a very dark place.
Oh, good. Tools. Can't do anything without tools. Plumber's only as good as their tools. I'm gonna need your help, please.
Come into my basement and I'll put a tool belt on you.
Set
me free, Annabelle.
You know what? I've got a big wrench. I don't want to hear what you've got. Okay. Let me see. Okay, let me get back in here because I think this is where the problem is. Let me see. I'm gonna need the pipe cutter.
Right.
And then I'm gonna need to take this valve right here. Okay, good, good. And remove the petcock.
Can you say it again, petcock? In a French accent, maybe.
And then I'm gonna have to solder it with a blowtorch and we should be good.
So you're gonna solder and blowtorch my petcock?
If you'll let me.
I will, and may I say thank you very much and welcome to Scotland. Listen, I don't think you should do it. Let me call Gavin and maybe the vice squad. You've got a filthy mouth.
Oh,
I'll be right back.
Oh, oh. Yeah.
Let me tell you something, Annabelle. I think you were absolutely brilliant there.
I had moisture in every crook and cranny and crevice that I didn't even know that I had.
It's a very nice alliteration.
And no, she's absolutely right. I mean, that is an occupational hazard. I vaseline my crack once a week, at the very least.
I remember my mother used to say, she would be so proud and she would say, "You, girl, are full of spunk." What? Is that bad? What?
Not at all.
Your mother was proud that you were full of spunk.
Yes, why? Why is that bad? No, what do you mean?
You need to tell her.
No. Tell me what?
I don't know. That's too good, I can't. I don't want
to. What? Stop it! What is
Annabelle,
it?
There's no way you would know this, but in Scotland, if somebody says that you're full of spunk...
Yes?
Aye,
it means
is... It's sperm. You know,
what?
Semen. Nut butter.
Ow! No.
Baby gravy.
Stop it.
Come on.
Stop it.
I'll call you a taxi.
Oh.
Strip club soda.
Oh, Lord.
I like that.
Dear Shelley, that's great news about the offers for the house and the store. I need to think about it for a while, but I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks for the listings you sent, but I'm not interested in purchasing real estate. I'm just all about new everythings these days. Take care, Annabelle.
You looking for movie times?
No, flight times. I've got a Roman holiday to get to.
What are you going to wear when you get there, a toga?
Maybe.
You really going to go through with it? The 20 countries of your 20 favorite movies.
Mm-hmm.
You're mad.
No, I'm not mad. I'm just kind of sad. The further away I get from Nantucket, the more I realize how small our world had become. You grow up, you fall in love, and your dreams start to disappear because you can't afford them. You struggle. And then you settle for a terrible word called enough, because you had enough. But then, in order to survive, you convince yourself that what you've had is enough. Does that make any sense at all?
So what you're saying, there's never enough?
Yes, but by the time you realize that, it's too late to do much about it.
So you keep doing what you've always done?
You go to the movies.
To retreat to a fantasy world?
Well, hopefully a happily ever after world. Isn't that what everybody wants?
I do like a happy ending. I think that's why my favorite movie is Silence of the Lambs.
Every time I think I could maybe like you, you just...
I interrupt you and remind you I'm an asshole.
The gang's out here with a tent.
Tent? Why?
There's a wedding on Saturday.
How wonderful. Who's getting married?
He's getting married.
Bring it down this way. What we'll do is we'll put it in the field over there.
Yeah.
The guests will come down the stairs, kind of promenade or parade or whatever they do, and come down there. You can set up on this level, and we'll put the doors here, and they can come down the stairs and walk right in. What?
Nothing. I'm just surprised, that's
but
all.
But someone would marry an asshole like me?
Kind of. No, that's just that I've been here for days and you never even mentioned it.
It's because some of us are not as comfortable talking about their personal lives as you are.
Well, I get that. That's fine. But, I mean, who is she? Who's the lucky lady?
Her name is Claire. We were at university together. She was actually my wife's best friend and roommate for a while.
Uh-huh.
We actually dated for a little while. And then she pointed out that she thought I was in love with her best friend.
And were you?
Who knows? I was 20 years old. Anyway, she moved to London and never came back and never did marry.
Because you were the love of her life.
That's what she tells me.
That's romantic, don't you think? I mean, to find each other again after all these years?
I don't know how romantic it is. She called me after my wife died and told me how sorry she was.
Well, that was nice.
She's a nice woman. Been very successful in business. Very attractive. Lovely, clean hair. I'm going fishing.
I'm coming with you.
No, you're not.
Oh, yes, I am. You said it was part of the odds and experience. Why can't
Because you're dressed like a shortbread tin.
I'll change my clothes,
then
okay?
Go change your clothes. But if you know anything about fishing, you know fish require quiet, no talking, no singing. Start now. Get practice.
What are you looking at?
She's American.
What? Howard, can we please go back to the inn? The midges are killing me.
You really have a hard time not talking, don't you?
Yes, where I'm getting eaten by midges, yes. I'm hungry.
So are the midges.
How long are you going to sit there while I get eaten up? They're not even biting you.
Oh, they're biting me. I'm just not making a big song and dance about it.
Oh, they're in my pants! No, don't jump! No! Why'd you jump in?
You didn't know you could swim!
Of course I can swim. I was a lifeguard in the entire
time. Man, I never came up! Oh! My foot touched something! My foot touched something!
Oh my gosh, you're such a baby!
I'm not a baby. There could be a shark in here!
What happened?
After I heroically dived in to save you, my boot came off and I think I must have cut it on something. Coming out.
Let me take a look and fix it. That's it?
Oh my gosh.
It feels deep.
Deep? It's a nothing burger.
I don't think you should call it a nothing burger. I could get an infection. They used to throw witches and plague victims and stuff in there. I could have some medieval botulism or something. Whoa, what's funny?
I just can't believe your foot.
What's wrong with my
foot?
It's
beautiful.
It is.
It's gorgeous.
It is. We do have beautiful feet in my family. In Scotland, we have beautiful feet. Is that antiseptic?
It's antiseptic. It's going to sting tiny, tiny bit.
Oh,
God.
Jeez.
I've got to get it clean.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to put a wee Band-Aid on it, okay?
Okay.
Oh, my gosh. I never took you for a mani-pedi kind of guy.
William Wallace started it in the 13th century. He would get a mani-pedi from a Korean woman in her broth. And all of the medieval kings wanted, thank you, wanted a shot of it. There you go.
Uh-huh.
All right, thanks.
Aw, is that a wee bit better?
I do have bad news, though.
What is that?
Well, there's no dinner because it was going to be fish.
We'll find something.
Are you going to help me?
I'm going to help you.
Thank you very much indeed. I just
don't
want to stand on anything.
So what are we having for dinner?
Well, I can't cook in this state, obviously, and you made me fire Giuseppe, so I'll take you to the village for dinner if we can find shoes.
Can I see your other foot when we get home?
Mrs. Wilson.
You know what I can't get over?
What can't you get over?
How light it is all the time.
Well, that's because it's Scotland, and it's light all summer and dark all winter.
And people just live with it.
They do. They have a lovely, nice red tan in the summer. All right, Morag. And they drink themselves to an early grave in the winter.
Sounds fun.
Yeah. Works for us.
Hello.
Hi.
And welcome. What can I get for you guys today?
Where are you from? You're not from Scotland, are you?
Yeah, I'm from California. I'm actually an exchange student here. It's a lot
really?
Of fun.
Yeah. Who did we exchange to get you? I think we probably had to send about half a dozen. The exchange rate is probably pretty high.
So what can I get you guys today?
I'd love a glass of Pinot Grigio, please.
Sounds great. And for you?
Big whiskey, please.
Okay. I'll be right back.
Thanks.
Sometimes I look at a just adorable young lady like that, and I think, I wonder what it's like to be her mother.
You don't have any kids?
No. No, we couldn't have any children. I was very good at conceiving them, but really lousy at actually bringing them into the world. Thank you.
Of course.
Thanks.
Lunch.
Lunch.
But anyway, talked about adopting, but Fred was, I don't know why, he was just so against it. He had this Nantucket generational thing that he just couldn't get over. And so by the time it was pretty obvious that we were never going to have children that way, and he was okay with adopting, I just felt too old. Too tired. Let's get drunk.
This is the worst whiskey in Scotland.
I'll bring the whiskey.
I really don't care for that song.
I'll bring the wine.
Yeah, well, look, you see, that doesn't make any sense. I'll bring the whiskey, I'll bring the wine. Shouldn't one person bring the whiskey and the other person bring the wine?
It's a duet.
Well, then
you never keep it on the radio long enough to discover that there's two people singing there. Why do you hate that song?
I don't know. It just seems it encourages alcoholism. What?
Sometimes you're very cute.
We don't talk about that around here, Mrs.
Okay.
You know what?
What?
You're good looking as well.
Wow.
As well as me. I'm still good looking. You're good looking, and so am I. That's what I'm saying.
Let's go someplace and get a good drink.
I know the very place.
Where?
Come on. Here, can you take them? Because they don't let dogs in here.
Oh, they're not welcome?
Well, they prefer attractive women, but you'll be fine. Come on.
Okay.
you. Now we've come to my favorite moment in the show. This is where I get to pick a little lady out of the crowd to come up with me and join me on this.
I'm the one for you right here. She knows every word.
She knows every word.
No. You've been singing it all the time. No. She knows every word.
Oh, no.
Annabelle. Come up and sing Whiskey and Wine.
Annabelle.
No, I cannot go.
Annabelle, you have to come join us.
No, I can't. I've got the dog.
Give the dog to your weird uncle. Let's go sing.
Oh, I hate you.
Okay.
Come on. Well, everyone, give it up for Annabelle.
I've been great little, I gotta be honest.
Do you know the song?
Everybody knows this song. Not everybody likes it, but everybody knows it.
This is a love song. Forget about all those people. They're not here. It's just me.
Even my weird uncle?
Yeah, especially forget about the weird uncle.
Weird uncle, I bastard.
Two, okay. Three, and...
Get my guitar.
I'll go and get mine. I'll wear my lace.
I'll wear my old leather.
We will make music together.
She's good. I don't care for her.
And I'll be your eye.
I'll keep up the tempo.
To keep us in time. We'll lose ourselves in sweet harmony.
He looks like one of those guys that smell of vomit.
What?
You left me hanging there on stage, and you left Wally at the bar.
What are you talking about? Wally lives at the bar.
Wally doesn't live there.
You weren't hanging on stage. You weren't hanging all over that man. No. You weren't hanging on stage.
I was not hanging on him. That's called performing. I'm getting you home. Come on, Howard.
No.
Come on. No. You're drunk.
Yes, of course I'm drunk.
Why are you drunk?
Because I've had a lot of alcohol.
Okay, that's it. Come on. I'm not sure this is a very good idea.
I'm fine. Please, leave me alone. I'm fine. Please.
Every man says they're fine when they're not fine. You know what the trouble with trouble is? You don't know you're in trouble till you're in trouble.
Okay, good. All right, on you go.
Great Broadway musical.
Okay, let's stitch that on a towel. All right.
You know what? I'm just glad I had a wonderful time without having so much alcohol.
Yeah.
I had a lovely time. That Jack Spence, oh boy, he is adorable. Love that hair. Could sing with him all night. How did Wally get home before we did?
Well, the dog's not drunk.
Good point.
How's your sandwich?
Heavy.
Yeah? Well, that's ham for you, isn't it? Go to bed.
Good night, Albert.
Good night, Annabelle.
Come on, Wally. Don't you just love dogs, Gavin? They don't care where they came from. They're just happy to be here. Thanks for walking with me.
Hey, that's genuinely no problem. I had a septic tank situation to attend to. But on these occasions, well, I tend to procrastinate a bit. Oh, Wally!
Oh, he sees that cat. See? No, Wally! No!
Wally, you're going to get full of thistles. See, this is Howard's problem.
What?
Howard with Claire. He's the dog, she's the cat. And as you well know, dogs and cats aren't allowed to mate. It gets messy. Mm-hmm. Thistles.
But isn't that for them to figure out?
No, that's my job. I'm Howard's best friend. I'm his only friend. And he's my only friend. He lets me go to the house to escape all the insanity of my life. And I go there to help him, well, from going insane. Hmm. In that big, lonely, stupid house. Which he loves, by the way.
I know.
But he can't afford it.
I didn't know that.
He's trying to hold on to it for his son. Anyway, that's where the cat comes in. She can afford the house, but she hates it. All she's interested in is that title, Lady Odd of Loch Lomond. Once she gets her hands on that, she will hightail her very sweet arse back to London, and Howard will be far more miserable than he is even now.
How can love survive in thistles?
Missus, people don't talk like that in our country.
They don't talk like that in America either, really.
No, Dolly, no! Howard, I need to speak to you for a minute, okay?
All right. Whoa! Somebody's looking for somebody, but they'd both regret it in the morning.
Well, a girl can dream, right?
Yeah, well, I'm afraid the pickings are slim here tonight. There's me the proprietor, or me the barman, or me the waiter, or there's that guy.
Go!
Yeah. The first of tonight's great thinkers.
Tough choice.
Well, I tell you what, I'll seat you between us both, and if he wakes up and belches and farts and kind of growls at you, then I'll make sure you get a straight shot.
You are so good to me, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Listen, I spoke to Gavin this morning.
Can you wait? Uh-oh. It's an existentialist estrogenic dream, is it not, gentlemen?
A what?
These testosterone-fueled individuals are here for a symposium at Glasgow University just down the road. They are all fueled up in the Hegelian dialectic, and it seems like you are the only member of the feminine persuasion in their midst.
What is that, Howard? I don't know what that is.
That's a very good question. See, they all think they know, but they don't know. Observe. Gentlemen. Who amongst you can explain to this relatively attractive but obviously uneducated woman the Hegelian dialectic, remembering to keep it simple because she is only a woman, and not just a woman. A woman who wanders the earth dressed as Mel Gibson and keeps her dead husband inside a box of chocolates. The Hegelian dialectic. George William Friedrich Hegel.
I've heard enough. Gentlemen, good evening.
Do you ever get tired of that view?
No.
It's like pulling teeth. What's up with you?
I don't think I can get married if my only son won't come to the wedding.
Right. So why is he not coming?
He doesn't approve of Claire.
Yeah, he's a smart boy, that boy of yours.
You don't like her either, do you?
Not keen, no. What age is George now?
29.
29? I remember that.
You are the staff, aren't you?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Can I talk to you for a minute, please?
No.
No, it's very important.
I don't want to talk to you.
I think you should hear this.
I don't want to hear anything you have to say, okay?
Well,
I'm on to you,
I
and I'm over this whole charade of yours.
It would be a great
you had
kindness
no right
to me.
To human-
Just stand there and listen to me for a minute. I lied to you about my wife.
You're not a widower?
No, I'm a widower.
It's my wife. Meredith. What's her name? Meredith Louise. She's a beautiful name. She has a beautiful smile and a beautiful big heart. Big enough for a sorry sod like me. Well, what happened was that she got very, very sick. The type of sick that by the time the doctors actually figure out what's going on, it's too late to actually do anything about it. And when she was gone, the only way I could get out of bed in the morning was to be angry. You know, I was angry at her. I begged her to go to the doctor, and then I was angry at God because I begged God to heal her, and he didn't do it, and that's all right because I don't believe in him. And then angry at myself because I should have moved heaven and earth to help her, but I didn't know what to do. See, this place, Odds Inn, there was no Odds Inn. This was our home. We lived here for 30 years. She's still here. She's in the urn on top of the mantelpiece. She wanted to be cremated too, and she was always complaining about being cold, so I thought I'd better put her next to the fire. Maybe I should laminate her and keep out the draft. All I'm saying is I'm sorry. You have been very open and honest and clear about your pain, and I've lied about mine, and I'm sorry. You're a better person than me.
No, I'm not. I've been acting too. When everybody acts and everybody lies, I do wear Spanx. And I know about your son. Kevin told me. It's all fine. It's all fine. We're just two people trying to do the best we can do. And so now I'm gonna go to Rome. They're gonna get married out there.
Claire, excuse me. Hello? Hi. Yes. No, everything's fine. Where are you? Did you fix the dress? Good. Right, well, no, not at all. It's fine. It's all going fine. Yeah, no,
look at you. You look fantastic. How was it?
Great.
You get it?
I did.
Okay?
Yep.
All right. So,
what's required of you next is something you should never do away from home.
What's
ever
that?
Again.
Oh, excited.
Yes. In you go.
Thank you.
Kit off, upstairs. I've got a couple of sticks of butter and a frog mask.
That's not the tent I picked out.
Ah, Annabelle. There you are. Meet Claire. Claire Hollings, this is Annabelle Wilson of Nantucket, Massachusetts.
Very nice to meet you. And congratulations.
Thank you. Are you enjoying Scotland?
Oh, what's not to love, right? It's just spectacular.
Annabelle fixed my plumbing.
Oh, look, Howard, it was just a petcock.
Yeah, but she fixed it so well. Annabelle and her husband Fred used to run a hardware store in Nantucket. She can fix anything.
Really?
Mm.
And is your husband here with you?
No, sadly, he passed away a little over a year ago.
Oh, so sorry.
She's a very interesting way of working through her grief. Tell her what you...
Howard, no. Claire doesn't want to talk about me. This is a very happy time in your life. I remember happy. You think it's never going to end. I'm gonna leave you two lovebirds, okay? Howard, I think I'm gonna go into the village, all right? To that little cafe where we rode the bikes the other night.
Okay.
Don't worry about me for supper. It's so nice to meet you, and I wish you and Howard all the happiness in the world.
Careful on the bike.
Oh, yeah, I will.
You rode a bike?
I did. You believe that? Can't remember the last time.
Where did you go?
Just to the village. Into the pub for a dram. Annabelle thought it'd be a good idea. Yeah, she was right. It was.
I'm sure.
Annabelle is good-looking.
Good-looking?
Yeah, beautiful.
Beautiful? Well, in a classical sense, like Da Vinci's Mona Lisa or a Rembrandt. Beautiful in that sense, no.
She described herself to me as completely ordinary. I don't know what that means.
You see, Claire, not ordinary. But you have to ask yourself, what do you really like about her? There's a reason things didn't work out back then. People don't change.
Oh, no, I think people change. They change as you want different things in life.
All right, then. What do you want now that you didn't want then?
Well, I'd like a sense of purpose to go with my pulse, I suppose. I mean, although I've stopped trying to get it from books. I used to want to try and explain the universe to myself. Now I think I'd just settle for being happy.
See this big house you live in? It's not worth a shit unless you're happy in it. I go home to Winnie and the kids every night, and all I get is shouting, bawling, screaming, swearing, snot flying everywhere. It's utter chaos. But you see, the thing is, it's my chaos. And they're the very reason I flush other people's shit down the drain every day. They need me. And I suppose, well, I need them. Oh. Look at this. Have you spoken to George?
No.
Well, he'll come round sooner or later. You were a good father. All right, watch this.
Oh, that's yes, okay.
So, where are we going to have dinner?
The best place in town.
The Loughlin Arms?
Oh, Howard's in.
Oh, Howard, you know I like to get out and about.
Well, we are out. We're out by the fountain. And we are about to be served my famous bouillabaisse by my infamous friend, Gavin.
Yeah, it must be hard to get good staff these days.
Oh, come on. There you go.
Darling, it looks delicious. Sorry, Gavin. I think I just had a long journey.
Me. You know, until yesterday, Annabelle thought I had a full staff.
Why would you care what she thinks?
I don't know. Pride, I suppose.
Pride?
Mm.
Howard, she's just a guest here. Nothing more. I can't even begin to understand why that woman's opinion would matter to you in the slightest.
Maybe I'm embarrassed about having to run an inn in a place that used to be my home, or I don't know, maybe I have a smidgen of dignity left. I mean, look, it's hard enough with you being so much more successful than I am.
You've never mentioned that to me.
Well, it's true. I used to have everything. You know, I had a beautiful, loving, supportive spouse. I used to have an interesting career. I used to have a home that nourished my soul.
I know all about what you've lost, but I'm supposed to be what you've found. Remember?
Claire, please.
I don't know what's come over you. I left this house last week, and you were a man who seemed to care about me and wanted to marry me.
I do care about you. It's just that...
Just what? Suddenly feel differently because this simple little woman turns up here from some godforsaken island in the Atlantic?
She's not that simple. She's complicated, like everybody else is complicated.
cracking on. She's sweet and smart and funny and nice.
And what else? More at home than I am in this sorry excuse for an estate?
Oh, hey.
I mean, it's embarrassing. I'm going to bring my designers down here immediately to see if they can figure out how to make it presentable. We can move down to London during the renovations.
Renovations? My family have been in this place for generations. You can change the carpets and the curtains, but you can't go messing around with the character of this magnificent...
Magnificent? Oh, okay. Howard, you're the one that needs to get out more.
You're right, I do need to get out. I need to get out of this wedding, and so do you.
What?
Let's be honest. You don't like my home. You don't like my best friend. You don't like my bouillabaisse. You don't really like me very much.
Stop it, Howard. You are being ridiculous.
Am I? Gavin asked me the other day what I liked about you, and I had to stop to think.
That's cruel.
No, it's not. What's cruel is two people using each other to get what they want. Not caring who they hurt in the process. Let's just be kind for a change.
I thought we were over Meredith, wanted a new life, an exciting life.
The irony is, I am ready for a new life. It's not with you. I'm sorry.
Do you want me to wrap this up for takeaway?
You're an asshole.
You all right?
No. Get up tomorrow, you won't be there. Claire, you're...
was a young girl from Nantucket who found a hole in a bucket. She knew it was there.
The mail came.
We call it the post in this country.
I just got the letter I've been waiting for. Oh, it smells good. Where's Claire?
Huh?
Claire, your fiance. Remember her?
Yes, of course. It seems she left London without everything she needed.
She can't get everything she needs here in Loch Lomond?
Apparently not.
Do you have a lot of family here still?
Yeah, you know, aunts, uncles, cousins, that kind of thing.
Did your father have a sister?
Yes.
She's still alive.
It's hard to tell sometimes with her. She's old and kind of doesn't move much. What's going on?
Did she ever get married, have children? Did she ever go to Nantucket?
What's happening?
Is her name Arlene?
Yes.
She's Fred's mother. Can you take me to her?
Sure. Yeah.
Okay. And can you take me to the train station after?
Okay.
Crazy, right?
Came to Scotland because you wanted to dress up like you were at Braveheart. I didn't think you were here on a mission to find out if your late husband was in my family tree. What else was in your post?
Everything. All the records from the cottage hospital in Nantucket. It was all there. Fred had just found out that he was adopted.
Your Aunt Arlene was working for a lovely lady named Mary Wilson on Nantucket one summer. Well, she got pregnant, but she was unmarried, so she knew she couldn't go home. She had the baby right there, and Mary Wilson adopted him, and that baby was Fred. Hello, Howard. Come to say goodbye, have you?
Hello, Arlene. No, I've come to say hello. How are you? You look great.
Honestly, shut up. Who's this?
This is my friend from America. She's from Nantucket, actually.
I knew this would happen at some point. Come and sit by me and let me have a look at you.
Hello, Arlene. I'm Annabelle.
Annabelle?
Yes.
You've come a long way, yes. Annabelle. Why? Yeah.
Because I had to, and I wanted to. But I was afraid to.
Well, I mean, what were you afraid of?
The truth, I guess, whatever that turned out to be.
The truth. Oh, I spent my whole life trying to hide it. It's the most complete and total waste of time.
What? You're saying that the truth is not important?
No. I'm saying the truth is the only thing that matters. Truth being... what happened to my baby?
He lived a great life. Until, I'm sorry. He died a little over a year ago. He was, he had just found out about you and he was making plans to come and meet you.
When he fell off the ladder.
You know?
Yeah. I've subscribed to the Nantucket Inquirer and... what's the other one? Examiner.
Yes.
Ever since I left the island.
Oh,
I know. I know all about you.
What is this?
It's my scrapbook. You must look at it.
Oh, my gosh, it's our whole family history. Oh, look. That's when we opened the hardware store.
Yes, it is.
Look at this is when
lifelong Nantucket resident.
Yes. Oh, my goodness.
There's a lot.
Oh, I have something for you, Arlene. I wanted to bring some of Fred's ashes home to his mother.
Oh, bless you, Eva. Thank you.
It's in this box because Forrest Gump was his favorite movie.
I mean, we had the same sense of humor.
And the same eyes. He looked so much like you. He was beautiful.
What you have to do, both of you, is to learn how to be happy again. Not easy. You have to work at it rather hard, I think. Well, you've got to take her home, Howard. Don't be a fool. Pick her up and take her. She's to go.
Goodbye, Arlene. I'll come back and see
will you.
Yes, I will. I promise.
It will be
you
nice.
Stay well.
I'll try.
Okay.
Cheerio, Arlene. Can I take a chocolate?
No.
Why not? You never eat them.
Which one are you going to have?
Well, I thought I could choose.
Oh, well, my favorite. Oh.
Do you want one?
No.
All right, then. I'll just take the plate. See you later. You know, that was strange. Weird, you know?
I thought it was very moving. It was to me.
I may be, eh? What do you think she meant when she said, Howard, take her home, don't be a fool? What was that about?
I have no idea. She's your aunt. I would think that you would tell me what she meant.
Maybe. Or maybe she meant...
what are you doing?
Taking you home.
I'm gonna miss my train.
Oh, no.
Yes, I am.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
And that's the only train in Scotland. What?
She clearly said, take her home, Howard. I was just taking instructions.
Yes, and she also clearly said, don't be a fool, okay?
She's a mad old lady. She doesn't know what she's talking
Howard,
about.
Howard, I've missed my train, which means I've missed my flight. I should be halfway to Rome by now.
Well, I tell you what. Tonight, I make you spaghetti and a meatballs. And you pretend you're in Rome.
Oh, fantastico. And then I can dress up maybe like a Audrey Hepburn. And you can pretend that you kind of find me attractive.
No, no, Audrey Hepburn, she's a small, like a steak. It's not good for me. Oh. I'm Italian, man.
Oh, see. So you want a little more meat on the bone?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, say it's like a Sofia Loren. Huh? Oh, yeah.
I'm going to take the luggage out of the trunk. And by the way, Wally is very happy to see you.
Grazie.
Prego. Prego. Come on.
I'll be your rhythm, and I'll be your rhyme. I'll keep up the tempo to bring us in time. We'll lose ourselves in sweet harmony, discovering each other what a lover should become. We were made to make music together, sing a song that goes on forever. So here we go in that sweet ebb and flow, up and down this crazy arpeggio. But it sounds so good, just like it should. Fly to the sky, float like a feather, cause we were made to make beautiful music together. Yeah, together.
Might give you my heart, girl.
I might give you mine.
We'll laugh as we watch all the planets align. We'll lose ourselves in sweet harmony.
Once again, my compliments to the chef. He really is amazing.
I'll be sure to tell him.
Do you think they can see us?
Who?
Meredith. Fred.
Oh. Well, you mean like looking down from heaven or something?
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm still wrestling with the whole Enlightenment thing.
Did you miss Meredith?
Yeah. You miss Fred?
Mm-hmm.
Think we always will?
Oh, God, I hope not. But now you have, you've got Claire.
Actually, no.
But she's coming back from London.
No.
Are you okay?
Right as rain on a Scottish plain. Which is something no one would ever say in Scotland. I don't know why I said it. Spending too much time around you. I have to go and lock up. Why don't you meet me for a nightcap in the fancy room? That's the one with the big fire and the big sofas. Everything's bigger in the fancy room.
Mm-hmm.
I'll lock up.
This was my late wife's favorite room in the house.
You saw that, didn't you? All of it?
Yeah.
But I agree with Meredith. It is the most beautiful room. It's mine, too. You know what it's got? It's got great bones. I can't believe I just did that.
Did what?
The thing with the forehead. Remember in the way we were? When Barbra Streisand does that to Hubble, oh my gosh.
Were you saying I need a haircut?
No, no, your hair's, no. I love that movie. I'd forgotten. It needs to be on my list.
Oh, I don't like that movie.
How can you not like that movie?
I'm Scottish. We're a stubborn people. Here's the problem. My crazy aunt Arlene was Fred's mother, which means the dead man in the sweetie box was my cousin, which means I really want to have sex with my dead cousin's widow the day after I dumped my fiancé. That is some sick shit, Annabelle, even for Scotland.
You talk too much.
The odds in experience. No talking, no singing. Just whoopee. On the shores of Loch Lomond, in a castle fit for a king or a plumber, love went kaboom.
This is Wilson. This is Wilson. Ow!
Where did you learn all of that stuff? I thought you were stuck in an island for 32 years.
I was, but I was in love. It came naturally to me.
Can I ask you a personal question?
Sure.
And Fred watch a lot of pornography.
I didn't find pornography sexy. I found Fred sexy. A big difference between making love and having sex, don't you think?
I don't know what I think anymore. Why didn't you hop back in and run and buy me one more time?
No, and I'll tell you why I'm not going to do that. Because I'm not going to miss another train because of you, Mr. Odd.
You can't go now.
Why not?
Because.
You think that because we spent one great night, I should change all my plans for you?
Yes.
Well, you're wrong. No, I gave up my dreams once for a man. I'm not going to do that again.
Well, you can't go. You're the best plumber in Scotland.
Gavin will get better.
You got skills Gavin will never have.
Is that a compliment?
It is a compliment.
Good.
There's another reason you can't go.
What's that one?
I'm pregnant.
We're cats and dogs. You know it. We just get into thistles and make a mess. No, we were not meant to mate.
What would you call what we've just been doing?
Grief.
No. No, grief is crying till you get no tears left. Grief is drinking until oblivion. Grief is getting tattoos to feel different pain. What we were doing was life-affirming. And all that moaning and groaning and screaming.
I didn't scream.
Well, somebody screamed.
You screamed, and many times.
Well, I was scared.
You had reason to be. See, the thing about last night is, I just had no idea you could be so tender.
Neither did I. I can't go yet. I'm still tender.
Oh, the old petcock.
Petcock's ruined.
I will call a plumber.
I'd call Gavin. He wouldn't know what to do with it. Scare him.
I am going to miss you a little bit.
I know. I'll miss you too.
Ah. What are you going to miss the most?
Your ass.
Oh, I don't have any ass.
I know, I missed it the first time as well.
What else are you gonna miss?
You. I don't understand why you're leaving.
Howard, I've told you. I have a list.
Well, you know what? Forget your list.
You know what? Slow down. You're going too fast.
While we're on the subject, Forrest Gump is a terrible movie.
Every woman in that movie dies because she has the audacity to leave the house. That's a misogynistic movie. I'm amazed that you're into that.
I didn't say I was into it. I said Fred was into it. We loved it. Hey, slow down.
Don't tell me to slow down on roads I've been driving on my whole life. I don't think that's really any of your business anymore.
You're going too fast.
What gives you the right to boss me around while you're leaving?
You okay?
Fred was never in that box, you know. He's in there, he's in your heart.
You have no fucking idea what's in my heart.
You're going the wrong way. The station's that way.
You know, Howard doesn't really like anyone. He lives in that house alone because he likes being alone. But he's different with you now. You know, Annabelle, I think you're probably meant to be here. The house is telling you. Fred's telling you. And he's in his own unartful way, Howard is telling you as well. You know, I think you're being pretty stubborn, if you don't mind me saying. And I thought us Scots had a monopoly on that bullshit. Would you like a sweetie?
We're gonna have to take the tent down, Gavin.
Why?
Well, nobody's getting married.
Gee, that seems like such a shame.
It's a tragedy. Shakespearean. Look. I'm not gonna say all those things that Americans like to hear. I'm not going to talk like I'm in a greeting card. We don't talk like that here, like they do in your movies.
So you never tell a woman that you're in love with her?
Of course we do. We just, you know, just don't say it that way. We say it like, your hair looks nice. Your hair looks nice. Kind of ash blonde. It's good look for you.
You're such an asshole.
I am, man, I'm an asshole. But I'm an enlightened one. And I'm all yours. Don't you sing. Do not sing. No. Please don't sing. It's not a good time. You're a good singer, but there's a time and a place.
So
many years I lived in the shadows, only flickering memories inside me, believing the sadness would never end, the stars would never shine again, and love would never be mine again. Then came you. Like an angel dancing just the way you do. Then came you. Like a miracle that's too good to be true. Then came you.
Hello, Dad.
Hello, son. I thought you weren't coming.
Aye, well, I changed my mind.
So did I.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Lord and Lady Odd of Loch Lomond!
Not that. You'll be sick of the sight of that by the morning. No, this is something else.
What is it?
This, my darling, this is my last secret. Come on.
Remember how I told you how bad off I was after Meredith died?
Yes.
Well, it was actually much worse than I said. It was Gavin who told me, Howard, you can't go on like this or you're going to die. You need to start building new memories or the old ones are going to kill you.
That's exactly what I said to Fred when I left Nantucket.
Well, you were both right. So Gavin helped me to literally start building my new life.
You built this? It's unbelievable. Swiss Family Robinson was the first movie I ever saw. It's perfect. Oh, my goodness.
I'm glad you like it, because, you know, with the wedding and the house falling apart and everything, I think we're going to have to live here. I'm kind of broke.
Well, I'm not. So we aren't. I made a fortune on the sale of my house in the hardware store. I've got millions of dollars. You married well, sir.
I didn't marry you for your money.
No, but you would have in an instant, wouldn't you?
Much faster than that. Welcome home, Lady Odd.
You have no idea how much I like your hair.
Don't get too cozy, Your Oddship.
Oddship?
We're going on a Roman holiday.
I'm excited.
You are?
Yeah, I am.
Oh, fantastico.
A journey you take one day at a time.
What is life but a song that you sing as you float on each note, lost in rhythm and rhyme?
What is love but a feeling of soaring above on a cloud?
What is love but a song that you sing and this need to sing it out loud? We all need to sing it out loud.
You don't find love, love finds you. In the midst of a moment right out of the blue. It sneaks up on your heart, hardly making a sound. Frame at a time.
From the ways that you grow to the places you go, from the meadows you cross to the mountains you climb.
Everyone writes their own movie. No one knows how it will end, but we can spend each and every new day trying to find a brand new way to say to the one who's become your best friend, I love you, I do, and the miracle of my life is you love me too.
And in this crazy world all around us,
love came and actually found us.
Love actually found us
once again. On your heart, hardly whispering a prayer, till all of a sudden you hear it, and love's right there. How could it possibly be? Love actually found you and
so many years I sat in the shadows, only flickering embers around me, believing the darkness would never end. Music would never surround me again, and beauty would never astound me again. Then came you. Then came you. Like an angel smiling just the way you do. Then came. So many years I lived in the shadows, only flickering memories inside me, believing the sadness would never end, the stars would never shine again, and love
would never be mine again. Then came you. Then came you. Like an angel laughing just the way you do. Then came you. You stepped out from the sunlight, startled my wounded heart. Then I started to feel again. That's when I started to heal. And then the idea of love became real again. Only when stepped into my wounded heart. That's when I started to feel again. I finally started to heal. And then suddenly love became real again. Only when. Then came you. Then came you. Like an angel dancing just the way you do. Then came you. Then came you. Like a miracle that's too good to be true.